bhakti yoga, in the science of gaining mastery over the emotions. For that, we saw that we have to recognize the two main qualities that we all are born with. Asuri Sampat and Daivi Sampat. Asuri Sampat is the one which we have to reduce and eliminate. There are wrong emotions. Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Mada, Matsarya. The six enemies of man, as we call. Anger, greed, jealousy, hatred, infatuation. All these things have to be reduced, thinned out, and eliminated. The process of elimination doesn't happen in one stroke. You have to thin down the emotions. Tanutum yati. Your master has said, how to reduce that? You have to thin out. Its power has to be reduced day by day, day by day. The strong emotions have to be diluted. Strong emotions have to be thinned out. And we develop the positive emotions. That is the Daivi Sampat. Tejya, Kriti, Kshama, Shaucham, Adroha, Radhimanita, etc. All the good qualities, full of mechanism, energy, dynamism every day. Tejaha, Kshama, forgiveness. Not only forgive ourselves, but we don't forgive others. What is the idea is, we have to forgive others before we forgive ourselves. We should be very critical about our own selves. What are the defects we have, what are the problems we have, what are the challenges we have, we should correct them. Dhruti, steadfastness. Take up a job, you should be there until it's completed. Adroha, no cheating, no corruption, everything should be transparent. Nati Manita, the ego should be reduced. All these things have the grand qualities that have been talked about, Krishna. So, why these things are called bad, why these things are called good? So, Krishna gives the next answer. Daivi Sampat Vimokshaya, Nibandhaya Asuri Mata. All those qualities will deteriorate us, drown us into tension, stresses, dukkha, or diseases, are called wrong ones. All those things which help us to go up, move towards freedom, Daivi Sampat Vimokshaya, to reach that state of immense bliss, immense knowledge, immense power, immense freedom. That is the thing which is called the good knowledge. Daivi Sampat Vimokshaya, Nibandhaya Asuri Mata. Having said that, Krishna says, now it's your choice. Do whatever you want. You are born already with good qualities. You go on increasing that good qualities. You also have the bad qualities. Go on reducing it. That's the way. So, Daivi Sampat Abhijatosi. You are born with good qualities, Arjuna. You don't have to worry. That good qualities go on developing. So we are all born with those good qualities. You must see that it goes on increasing, increasing, increasing. Day by day, consciously you grow. That is the process of getting mastery. All the negativities, day by, you must go on reducing. That is the dimension. And having said that, he says, you must start seeing all these good qualities everywhere. In everybody, there is divinity. Each soul is potentially divine. You have a choice to see good in others or see bad in others. Antosti bhavati vyanam, bhutiyanantya parantara. Desha suddesha sattvata, vibhutiyan vistaromaya. In the shloka that he is talking about in this, let us chant. Nantosti mama divyanam. Human beings, the demons, and the gods They all went to the great Lord Vishnu. Please give us some advice. Da. Everybody understood. What did they understand? Rakshasas, the demons, they said they have become very cruel. Cut others, beat others, terrorize others. So what he had told? Daya. Daya is compassion. So develop the quality of daya or compassion. What about devatas? Devatas are always in superstar culture. Sense pleasures, eternal youth, richness, comfort, everything increasing. What is to be done? You don't become slaves to the emotion, control over your senses. Dama. Dama means control over the external senses. Vahinindriya nigraha dhamaha. Ashyakrathana Purshya. What about human beings? You have become very selfish. You don't care for others. Don't look at others. You don't share anything with others. Everything for me, everything for me, everything for me. Dana, sharing. Therefore, the three qualities of the sattva and daivi sattva have been given here as advice. Dana, daya, dama. Dana is sharing, daya is compassion, and dama is control over the self. This allows that we have to start developing. Previous thing, how to bring it? Every day share. Go on giving. Something or other you have to give. What you can give, if you have money you can share. If you got clothes you can share. If you got food you can share. Well, I don't have all these things, I cannot do that every day. I am not that rich to go on giving the money to people every day. Therefore what he says, not very. Patram, pushpam, halam, toyam. One leaf. You are coming here, you are doing fruit flowers and you have fallen out of the tree. Some nice leaves have come down. Just pick it up. And give it to your friend. Give it to the person whom we meet. Have one cup of water. Somebody is very thirsty. You go there in your dining hall. Give one cup of water. Phalam. The fruit has come. And take that fruit and give it to you. So, the habit of giving has to be developed. What to give is not that important. The process of giving itself is going to bring about the transformation. Then what happens? You develop the daivi sampad. This process of giving in love is called prema. In prema bhava, it is always giving and giving and giving without expecting anything in return. In the lower form of love, you give something, you expect something in return. Okay, we are good friends, I am going to give you this. Your nice thing that you like, nice rasgulla I will give you. I want that you also should give me. My point is what? Gulab jamun. Expectation by return in the grass form of love. In this daivi sampad, what you are doing? Go to the next step, called prema. In prema bhava, you go on giving and giving and giving. By that process of giving, you develop daivi sampada. By the result of that, you become happier day by day. You start growing towards that freedom. So we used to have our vice president, Sri Chandrasekhar, who was a big judge in the Allahabad High Court. And he is the one who handled Indira Gandhi case. After retirement, he came back, and in our committee, he was the vice president. And what he was doing, he was getting at that time pension 40,000 rupees. Then he calculated how much money I need every month, including the tax, electricity, water, everything, take care of food. 8,000 rupees is enough. Because he had his own house, everything he calculated, kept some emergency. So 10,000 is more than adequate for me. So why should I have my 30,000 with me? And when one came here, 34. Two different people. bulk he'll give. Every day he'll give sometimes, or sometimes he'll give the whole bulk, you know. And giving became such a part of his life, dana. And some people ask, why you gave away all these things? What is going to happen? Something happened. Bhagavan is there. God is going to take. Giving. He says, unfortunately, the modern community have lost the joy and bliss associated with giving, he said. In giving, there is more happiness than acquiring. Every mother knows vatsalya bhava. When the mother gives to the child, she is so happy. Compared to eating her son, if she gives to the child, so happy. So this is the deeper understanding you have to get. In giving, there is more joy, more bliss. Therefore, Krishna is telling, develop this positive thing of priya bhava. Imagine a society, everybody goes on giving. How wonderful society it will be. It will become an ideal social order. This is what India had built. For hundreds of years, people used to come from all over the world. And here, there's so much of transparency, so much of honesty, so much of giving. Atithi devo bhava. Anybody who comes from outside, you need to treat them as God. Give food to them. You go to the village, even today, you can see that. If you go there, villagers will be very happy. There is no appointment. Atithi means a person who goes without atithi, without an appointment. Today everything has to be by phone and appointment. I'm going to come. He will say, no, I'm very busy. Why don't you come tomorrow? That's not atithi. Just go without any appointment, and the villagers, they have cooked only for themselves, but they will be very happy to feed you. And even if they don't get, doesn't matter. That is the prayer bhava, that is the vatsalya bhava, giving. Therefore, go on giving. The light starts coming and the darkness goes away. This is the beautiful thing that we are seeing in this wonderful verse. That is the process of bhakti. To raise towards prayer bhava. In such ideal society, people used to come, they used to give the money with somebody and go somewhere for a pilgrimage and comes back after 3 months. The person will give the money with some interest. No cheating. Absolutely everything was so honest. What is the result of that? India became very rich, you know, and it became the richest country in the whole world. People were selling diamonds, silver, gold in the street. People were coming to India not just to acquire philosophy. They were coming here getting attracted with the money. When they came here, they saw the daivi sampath, so much prevalent, so much of love, so much of affection, so much of hospitality, so much of honesty, so much of transparency. They were amazed. And people like Vyakhasthanis and other great historians came. They said, this is the most amazing society that we have seen in the world. Everybody giving. So much of love, happiness, health. All are going to come out. So when we develop our daivi sampath, all these things happen. This is yoga that is needed. That diseases will come down because agni is going to come down. And we become healthier day by day. So this is the wonderful thing that we have to contemplate. Start seeing God in everybody. Start seeing daivi sampath in everybody. There is plenty of such great things that are happening in the world. So a lot of press people come to me recently and I have been telling the press media has a great role to play in the whole world to bring about the transformation in the country. So what you are doing? Always you are highlighting the asuri sampath, you know, never the daivi sampath. Do you think there are not good things happening? There are hundreds of organizations who are doing fantastic work, great work, sacrificial work, selfless work. What do you to project them? Why do you project all negative things that happen here and here? Okay, do that. That should be say 20%, 30%. Remaining 70% should all be good things. Then the positivity will grow. This shloka will come into manifestation. Therefore, the media has to come out. So many of you use this social media. Facebook, some of you do that YouTube and other things. You must spread this good thing. Every day, bring something good. Twitter or various social media we have, we are used to it. Start sending the good thing, good thoughts to everybody. Then things will start transforming. So not only we should grow, we should see that the surrounding also grows and we move towards ideal social order. Therefore, by developing the Daivi Sampad, seeing good everywhere, that is the second dimension, social dimension is bringing up. It's got to come up in a wonderful way, and we have to create ideal India. We have to bring back a grand ideal social order that we had in our country back again. That is responsibility of all of us. For that, we have to transform. Let us contemplate on this thought, sit straight, with eyes closed. Relax all parts of the body from toes to head. Relax your whole body, beautiful smile on the face. Scan your life. How we are born with all good qualities. And are we developing the good qualities or we are not? Just observe ourselves. Can you make a conscious resolve today, a sankalpa, that from today onwards I am going to develop my positive virtues, all the grand virtues that I have, great creativity, all good qualities I have. That is the light. I bring light into my life. Make a resolve, make a sankalpa. Consciously you must do that. Every day in the night you must write the diary. How many good things we did today. Then negativity is automatically go away. You see so much of joy, so much of happiness, so much of health, so much of development will take place. And become part of this great vision that our Prime Minister has taken to turn India back to its original glory, even bigger than the earlier glory that we had, ideal social order, everywhere giving transparency, development, love, affection, control over the senses, and everything. Dana, dana, dana. Look at all the schemes that he is bringing, everywhere this dimension of dana. Those people who can afford to take no subsidy for the gas, why don't you give that gas to the poor people, redistribute? 2 crores of such things came up in the country. So we should all start working in the direction and see that we make India in the great stage which it had once. We and we in the formula given by Swami Vivekananda. So let us change, let us make a sankalpa, write an idea, day by day, day by day. Let us change and see that we develop a wonderful community, the great country India. Come to Namaskar Mudra.
Yeah.